I, Professor Khyati Patel, from Applied Science and Humanities Department, welcome our speaker, Dr. Mukesh Patel, sir, on behalf of SNP IT and RC Umbraak. In today's workshop, it's my privilege to introduce Dr. Mukesh Patel, sir. Dr. Mukesh Patel, sir, is an assistant professor at Department of Mathematics, UKA Tarsadia University, Bardoli. He is having had 14 years of teaching and research experience. His research area is artificial intelligence recognition of human research area, image processing. He has published more than 25 papers at national and international level. He delivers expert talks in many events. Under his guidance, many students have completed PhD and many others are pursuing. Now, I hand over to session Dr. Mukesh Patel, sir. Sir, please.
Hello.
Hello.
Am I audible, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let me share my PPT. Okay. Is it visible? Hello. Hello.
Yes, it is visible, sir. It is visible.
So shall we start?
Yes, sir. Sure.
Okay. Good afternoon all, welcome you all in the afternoon session. Mansi for giving me an opportunity to interact with such an enthusiastic audience, because after our lunch, I hope we will try to maintain our enthusiasm as well. So come to the topic. So now we are going to discuss on the topic is digital image processing. As we know that in the digital era, in this digital era, basically, most of the things are going to be converted into the digital form. Many of the things which are related to the digital, like signal, sound processing, especially the image processing. Image processing is a wide field. Much of the research work is going on in this particular area, like enhancement of image, image quality, transmission of the data, storage of the data, security purpose. All kind of work is going on in digital image processing. But not only that, some other things which are most important in digital image processing, which is the classification. Nowadays we know that everything is going to be converted into artificial intelligence form, knowledge management system, and then artificial intelligence is there, in which we require much stuff in the image processing. There are certain stages of image processing, starting with image normalization, then it comes to the feature extraction, then compression, classification using artificial neural network or CNN, RNN, slowly and gradually it is moving towards the machine learning and deep learning. Nowadays people are working much on this particular area, because we are moving towards the robotic technology, where in place of human, we are going to use humanoid. Sophia is one of the best example of this particular robotic field. Not only in the field of computer side, but in every field, whether it is a medical, whether it is a engineering, mechanical, electronics, electrical, much of the things is converted into the artificial intelligence form, where image is giving its wider role in this area of research. Why we are talking about only on the high research in the digital image processing? As a lay person, layman, most of the people we are using smartphone, and the smartphone basically is used for two major purposes. One is the surfing, and second one is clicking of pictures and uploading on social media, because this generation is very, very much active on social media, in which we are very much, you know, passionate about to click our selfies and pictures and share onto the social media platform, where the quality of the image is very, very much essential, and as well as the consumption of data during transmission of this particular digital image over the network is very much important. Nowadays, we know that camera of mobile, and not only mobile but the televisions and some visuals object or instruments are having capacity to capture high definition images. As you know that we have a HD and high ultra HD QLED technology, so in which a high amount of data is transmitted over the network, whether it is a television, whether it is the internet or any other platform over the network. So in which the processing of image is very much important regarding this particular task. Okay, so there are so many stages, but here in this particular session we are going to discuss the preliminary stage, that is the image normalization or image enhancement, and how mathematics, a small mathematical model or mathematical techniques are helpful to enhance the image during image processing. So these are the overall scenario of this particular outline of this particular presentation. So what we are going to cover in this particular session. So let's begin. But before we go towards the digital form, artificial digital form created by the human being, we have to understand how human has created this particular digital form of the digital form of any object. So the human has basically followed the natural phenomena of a human eye. So let me brief introduction, or you can say brief discussion on the image formation in human eye, and how this similar concept is used by a human being to develop a digital instrument. So as we know that sun is the ultimate source of light, so illumination source is light. Illumination source of light is nothing but the sun. A light is coming through the source, and it is come to the any object of this particular earth, and the light is reflected from the object and entering into the human eye, in which, just a second, yeah, in which we know that the first we have an optical center in our eye. The light is passing through the optical center, this is a lens, and then it is captured on the retina, where the most important part of the retina is fovea. We will discuss later how it is work over there, which sensor is applicable over there. So here the picture has been captured in an inverse form, and then after by the optical nerve it's come to our mind and the object is visible. So this is a general phenomena of the human eye, which convert any physical object into form of digital form, and it is visualized by our human mind in digital form. So there is a limitation of ordinary camera, that is our artificial camera, in which the lens they are using, which is not flexible. That means the distance between when the light is coming from the object and it is passing through this particular lens, in ordinary camera or artificial camera, the length of the focus length of the particular glass or lens is not going to be changed because it has a fixed length. So either you have to two things if you want to visualize the object. One, either you have to change your focal length of the particular lens, or either you have to displace the camera forward or backward. So as usually our camera does not have a capacity to change the focal length, so obviously we always zoom in or zoom out the focal length of the lens of the particular camera, through which we can adjust the picture on our retina. But human eye has a capacity where lens can change its focal length by changing its shape. So it is no need to no need to displace our eye forward or backward. हम अपने body से बाहर आँख को आगे पीछे नहीं कर रहे, बस just lens is changing its focal length to adjust the pictures on the particular retina. So this is the advantage of human eye. So this is the adjustment done by the human being. Okay. Now every object is not visible because actually we are not visualizing any object. We are actually visualizing the lights coming from the object. So the illumination source sun have different type of lights coming from the sun: radio wave, microwave, infrared, visible spectrum, ultraviolet, x-ray, gamma. They have a different frequency, they have a different wavelength. But if you see the electromagnetic spectrum, it's a wide range of the frequency of the or wavelength of this particular different kind of lights, from which we can only see the object which belongs to the light coming from the object belongs to the visible spectrum only, and it is a very narrow visible spectrum in which we are enjoying the beauty of this particular life, a beauty of this earth. Okay, so if you observe the wavelength, frequency or energy, so here is the visible spectrum. On the left hand side you can see it is a low energy radiation and a high energy radiation, and here we are having the visible spectrum. The light spectrum that the wavelength we are varying from 400 to 700 nanometers, in which our eye has a capacity to identify, to recognize the particular object. So this is the actual visible spectrum in which the whole world is visible. Other than that, yeah, there is a light, but our eye has no capacity to visualize. We know that we are very much clear about radio waves, which is used in television, microwaves, infrared waves, ultraviolet, we are using x-ray and gamma rays, but our natural eye is unable to visualize this particular light. So you know, we are using different instrument to visualize this particular particular waves or the light. So visible spectrum is the only spectrum in which we can visualize the thing. But how it is visualized? Because every light has to be captured or have to be observed by particular sensor. It should be sensed by the sensor. So what kind of sense? The natural senses are available in our human eye. There are two types of senses in our human eye. One is cones and second is rods. So basically, the cones have the capacity to identify the colors of the particular object, and as we know that every color is a combination of RGB, so the colors of coming from the object is identified by the cones sensors, while the dimension or the shape of this particular object is sensed by the rods. So on the retina there is a little bit region which is called a fovea, where the degree from -20 to +20, or you can say that from left to right, from the center of the optical axis or visual axis, the 20 degree in which majority of the cones and rods are there, where object is captured or sensed by the particular lens. Okay, so as we know that fovea is a 1.5 mm diameter region, and retina has in size of 1.5 by 1.5 retina, where 150,000 per meters per square elements are there, where eye is about 337,000 elements over there, which capture the colors of the particular particular object. Not only that, this is the natural phenomena where cones are able to capture the colors of the light. But nowadays we know that if we see the light, if we see any object which is not that much qualitative, but when we capture pictures in your phone or any professional camera, the visual quality is much better than the natural phenomena. That means what we are seeing, which is the captured image, is much better than the visualized image, which means that nowadays the technology is enhanced, which crosses the human cap, which crosses the capacity of human eyes or the sense of the human eyes. Okay, so how this digital image can be digitalized or digitally captured by the instrument, the similar phenomena as usual, the illumination source of light reflected from the object, and there is an aperture which control the light to enter in this particular camera, and there is some sensors which will capture the colors, dimension, shape of the particular object, and then after it is converted, it will convert it into the voltage waveform. Okay, so directly come to the sensor of this particular digital world. Most of the basically there are two types of sensors. Maybe nowadays there is another soft sensors are available, but CCD and CMOS are the most commonly used sensor. It's an array sensor which will capture the image in a two-dimensional form. The whole image, once you capture, it is converted into the 2D, two-dimensional form. So in a CCD, there are 4000 by 4000 elements or more in a very small chip of this particular object. Now, when the object is captured by this particular sensor, so how mathematics is involved, how it can be calculated, how the image can be formed on this digital way. So let me discuss on it. A lit function I of xy is an illumination source of light, and R of xy is nothing but the reflection of the light from the object. And the sensor is imaging the system. Image system is sensing this particular object, and it's converted in a digital form. So in a digital form, you know that every image has a pixel, and every pixel having some values. Let me discuss about it. The function f of xy, I'm not going much about the mathematical particular formula or all this stuff. The function f of xy is the output of this combination of illumination source and the reflection light, and which is the nothing but the multiplication of I of xy into R of xy, which is form of a digital object, and every pixel is denoted by f of xy. Okay, so as in a previous session of Dr. Jay sir, he has discussed that every image is a matrix. Yeah, definitely it is a matrix, because if we see, there is a pixels is nothing but rows and columns array, and this is nothing but a matrix array. As usual, we note that every image is a combination of three colors, R, G, and B, and the intensity value of each pixel is varying from 0 to 255, because our eye has a capacity to visualize only this object, only the color. Its intensity or pixel value is varying from 0 to 255, because 0 is a complete black and 255 is a complete white. So our eyes are not see beyond that particular whiteness. So the capacity of human eyes is varying from 0 to 255 only. So RGB color image, there is a combination of particular object. So if we extract the image, you will get three different matrix. One is of red component, second is of green component, and third one is a blue component. And every, if you see, this is the original image, and I have captured this image and separated through the MATLAB or the open source of MATLAB. And this matrix is coming from the particular software. So the software explore the particular pixel value of image, where you can see that maximum value of the pixel is 255, where the minimum value is 0, and remaining intensity is varying from 0 to 255. So this is the matrix representation of the particular image. So whenever you capture image, color image, basically in the form of RGB, red, green, and blue, you have three different matrix. Suppose you are capturing any image in a gray scale or black and white form, a gray image, then obviously it has only one matrix, and the matrix is varying from 0 to 255 definitely, and where 0 is a black and 255 is a white, you will get a black and white kind of image. Not exactly black and white, but it is varying from black to white. It is called as a gray image. Okay, how it can be converted into gray image? Because as I have discussed with you that you have a camera in mobile phone, smartphone. There is some tools in your camera, you can see that. So everyone has a capacity to capture an image in a different different form. Different effect can be given. If you normally capture the image, the image is always in the form of RGB or color form. but there is a tool or application or particular effect is available where you can change the image into black and white form. Now again, a black and white has a HD black and white and ultra HD black and white and something kind of this. So obviously nowadays the technology is enhanced and you have this kind of image you can capture in a black and in a gray form, HD gray form also. So what actually working behind it, the behind scenario of the conversion of the color to gray image is there is a relationship RGB to YIQ color space, where YIQ color space is a national television system community video standard NTSC. The lumination Y, lumination means gray color Y, is a grayscale information. Then I is nothing but a prominence information contained in I, orange blue, and Q is nothing but purple green. There is a relationship between RGB and YIQ with the coefficient matrix 1, 1, 1, 0. This is the matrix, standard matrix. And now suppose, as far as the mathematics is concerned, once the image is converted into matrix plane, you can play with it. You can apply the mathematical fundamentals or mathematical techniques to process the particular matrix. So here the processing says that the YIQ is nothing but the inverse of this matrix into RGB. So it is nothing but A inverse B. So if you solve this equation, system of equations A inverse B, definitely you will get the inverse of particular this image or matrix. And if you see the matrix multiplication according to which equal matrices are there, concepts of linear algebra, where Y is equal to 0.22989 into R, 0.5870 into G, 0.1140 into B. Here is the relationship. That means if you want to convert a pixel having red, green and blue component, any three different values, and if you multiply that pixel value R with 0.2989 plus G pixel value with 0.587970 and B with the value of 0.01140, this pixel value is converted into the gray form. Definitely it will be converted. So this is how, once you click that effect in your camera or in your mobile, there is some calculation going on which multiply the matrix multiply or this multi basic equation is following the whatever RG and B components or whatever image you are capturing, it will convert this RGB image into gray image immediately, the fraction of second, where grayscale is varying from 0 to 255, where 0 is completely black and 255 is completely white. So this is how we can convert this image from RGB to gray image. Okay, and this is again, this is a gray image matrix. Again, this value, intensity value is varying from 0 to 255. No value is going beyond this 255. Okay, because as usual, our human eye is only capable to visualize the image from 0 to 255 only. If you want to enhance the visual quality, there are so many things are going on that we are going to discuss in this particular session. Okay, now when we capture image, mathematicians are always believe in error. So why not we not find error in this particular image? Because the image is ultimately it's a matrix. So when you capture error, when you capture image, image has definitely error. There are two types of error. One is noise and second is saturation. Noise is nothing but some black dots over there, and saturation, that means what? The white spot over there. So this kind of noise can be happened due to the environmental factor, due to the instrumental factor, and so many things are there, because ultimately it is about to capture light, about to capture light reflected from the object. Okay, so I will give you some of the examples one by one, in which case what kind of noise are there, what kind of error are there, how it can be removed, how we can overcome this particular error and enhance the visual quality of particular image using mathematical calculation. So some of the small formula or small techniques of mathematics which will help us to improve the quality of the video. This is the first stage of particular image processing, that is image normalization. Thereafter, you know that ki visualization of any object is representing the half of the existence of the particular object. If visualization is, the quality of the visualization is better, then after that, suppose you want to find the features, some of the features of the particular object, the features can be easily and improvised way you can capture from the particular object. if the features are very much significantly differ and significantly quality wise, then further process for classification or compression or security purpose of view, further image processing becomes very easier. So first step is very important. That is why today's session I am talking about this. Okay. Okay. So some of the things, mathematical techniques which are useful for the particular image enhancement. One of the most important thing is interpolation. As you said, in engineering field, also you have a numerical analysis over there, in which you have an interpolation and extrapolation topic in numerical analysis, where interpolation is very, very much useful. Interpolation says that something is missing within an interval. Something is missing within an interval. With the use of the surrounding value of that particular interval, you can derive this particular missing value, and this is the main objective of this interpolation. So why we are not, why should not we use this interpolation concept in an image? Okay, so basically the interpolation is used for zooming, shrinking, rotating, and geometrical correction of this particular object. There are some techniques over there, like nearest neighborhood interpolation formula, bilinear interpolation formula, bicubic interpolation formula, which will fill up the particular gap or particular missing points in within the object. One more thing, suppose an object is there. Let me give an example. Suppose you have captured an image in your camera with low resolution. Low resolution means the number of pixels in a particular image are lower, matlab dimension is lower, rows and columns are, you know, like height and width. Suppose you want to zoom this image, aap uski badi copy karwana chahte ho, you want to laminate this particular picture in a big size. What you will do, you just stretch, just pick up the corner and stretch this particular object. Can we do this? Kaisa kar sakte hain so that it becomes bigger one? Hello. Suppose we want to zoom this particular image in lamination. We want to laminate this image in a bigger poster. We have taken a low resolution image and we have to just stretch the image. Can we do it? And if we do it, then what happen?
Yes, sir. We can do it.
Yes, we can definitely do it. But what happen if the image is a low resolution? If we stretch the image, what happen? Have you experienced such kind of thing?
Yes, sir.
What happened?
I have experienced that. Actually, I cannot express what it will be become, but we will not get clear image.
Yeah. So when we yes, exactly. The image quality is not that much clear. Why? Because suppose your pixel is, I'm just taking an example. Once, no, this is not actual size, but for example, I'm suppose taking an example. Okay, this is suppose 1 cm by 1 cm of pixel. This is not 1 cm by 1 cm, but I'm taking just an example. Suppose your pixel value is 1 cm by 1 cm or 1 mm by 1 mm. Okay, if you stretch the image, you are increasing the dimension of the pixel. That means you become it's a five time bigger. Then you have to increase each pixel by 5 mm to 5 mm. So what happened when you stretch the image, you are not enhancing the quality of video, but you are just scaling the image. What happened? Pixel is visible, aapko pixels dikhne lag jayenge and blur image dikhegi, it's not clearly visible. So in place of many softwares are available, what they are actually doing, they are using interpolation formula. You have a Photoshop over there, you have a open source GIMP over there, and so many image processing ready-made commercial software are there where image can be zoomed by maintaining their quality. How it is? You are not stretching the pixels. Suppose your pixel having 100 by, sorry, your image having dimension 100 by 200. If you stretch the image, your pixel size is increased, but the number of pixels are 100 by 200 only. So pixels are visible and the images become blur. It is not clear quality of the image. In place of enhancing the dimension or scaling of the particular pixel value, let me add some more pixels. So in place of 100 by 200, let it be 500 by 1000. So if you add some pixels in the particular image, but what happened when you have captured an image, it has only pixel you have used 100 by 200, and out of each, sorry, 100 by 200. And what you are doing now, you are adding some more pixels. 4 times more pixels you are adding. But what colors they have? Or if you add them, either they are black, they are white, or whatever kind of that, if you add simply, then definitely they are the spots on the particular object. Object ke upar wo spots hi dikhenge, because the colors, actual colors in the image, which is not matched with this particular added pixels. So what happened? Image interpolation, that is the beauty of this interpolation formula. What interpolation formula is doing? Suppose there are 5 pixels and 1 pixel is adding into the particular group of the pixels. Ek pixel aapne add kar diya. Then what happened? What will be the cover of the color of this particular pixel? So interpolation is doing that. The interpolation sense that he in this interval, remaining all surrounding values are surrounding or neighborhood values are known. On the basis of that surrounding value, the missing value of this particular pixel is to be found. Okay, so interpolation will found the particular value of the pixel and it assigned the appropriate color to the particular pixel, such that it cannot be that much visible, or it definitely matches to the surrounding pixel. And in that way, in this way, you are enhancing or you are zooming this particular image. So how different kind of interpolation are used? Nearest neighborhood, bilinear interpolation, or bicubic interpolation. Where bicubic interpolation is the most important, where you can see that the nearest neighborhood value, which is used, the value is predicted on the basis of nearer neighborhood, while the bilinear is using surrounding, probably 4 to 8. Okay, value, while the 16 nearest neighborhood value are used by the bicubic. So more pixels you are using, you will get a more accurate results. Okay, so this is how you can zoom in or zoom out the image, not just by stretching, but with the adding some pixels or reducing by reducing some pixel. And you have to maintain the quality of this particular picture. So this is the role of interpolation. Not only this, you know that when some pictures or some photographs are captured by CCTV camera, sometime the half of the picture, yani 50% picture, yani one side of the face of particular person is captured, from which it is not clearly identified the person, because on the half portion of the image, it is not, you know, the person is not, the face of the particular person is not visible. So what you will do, you can add, you can use the interpolation formula, and you can predict the remaining portion of the face, and you can get a frontal face through which you can identify the particular person, the face of the particular person. There are so many applications of interpolation. So keep in mind, interpolation role is to enhance the image, improvise the image, and make the fulfillment. Another form of image processing, especially the enhancement, is intensity transform and spatial filter. So as usual, when you want to enhance the image, or you want to enhance the contrast level of a particular image, then you have to use contrast stretching function. Okay, this contrast stretching function, it has some property we will discuss later on. Thresholding value, yes, you are very much clear about the threshold value. At particular threshold value, if the value, pixel value, is less than the threshold value, it's become dark, yani zero kar dega. And then suppose it is the particular value, the pixel value is more than this particular threshold value, it's become lighter. So this image can be, if you want to get a black and white kind of image, definitely you will use the threshold value. In your mobile phone, in our mobile smartphone, you have a, you know, display setting where you want black and white kind of visualization of in your mobile. You just click the system, it will decide a threshold value, and automatically the whole visualization of whole features, whole all apps will be visualized in the black and white form. So thresholding value is using over there. So this is a very simple example of thresholding the value and contrast stretching function. Let me take an image, 4x4 size. This is the MATLAB output of this particular matrix. Some value, and I'm talking about only gray. If you want to perform a RGB image, we have to take 3 different matrix. So for you know, for better understanding, I'm focusing on a gray level value only. So here there is an image having different value, 4x4 pixel values over there, and minimum intensity of this particular image is 10 and maximum intensity is 120 actually. Okay, so now I want to convert this image into the using thresholding value. So I have to decide thresholding value, how much you are going to become going to make this image black or dark, or how much you are going to make this image white. It's depend upon threshold value. So threshold value I have chosen is 80, suppose, and the function, a simple mathematical query over there, S is the output and L is an input. So sorry, L is a maximum intensity over there, then S can be output. The condition says that if the value of R, which is greater than 80, yani the value of input value, which is greater than threshold value, it becomes L minus 1. What is L? L 2 raised to n, 2 raised to 7, 120. I will discuss this, what is L and 2 raised to n, why it is so. L minus 1, okay. And suppose the value R, which is less than or equal to 80, then it is converted to 0. That means either your image value is become 0, yani black, or either it's become a maximum, that is, in this our case, it's become 128. Okay, so yes, I think all of you are clear about the bits. Okay, so bits, binary bits, 2 to the power, 2 raised to 0, 2 raised to 1, 2 raised to 2, up to 2 raised to, you can go ahead. But as far as the intensity's value, intensity value of any pixel is varying from 0 to 255, so total 256. 0 to 255, that means it's a 256. So 2 to the power 8 converted, it's the maximum conversion of this particular pixel value to the power 8. So maximum intensity value is 2 to the power 8. So here, if you take 2 to the power 8, that means the 8-bit image. It's a 8-bit image, but here I have taken this matrix having maximum value is 120. So 7-bit is enough. 7 bits are enough to store this particular image. So if I take 2 raised to 7, it is 128. Okay, and L minus 1, that is nothing but 128 minus 1 is only 127. So if the pixel value is greater than threshold value, it is 120. It converted into 127, any highest value of this particular bit. And then if the pixel value is less than or equal to 80, then it is converted into 0, yani black. So the range of the grayscale value is between 0 to 127 only. So it is not completely white. If you see this image, this white part, this is not actually white, it is a gray, because actual white image is 0 to 255. If in this particular example, suppose I take any pixel value more than 128 or 127, okay, suppose I have taken 130, definitely if I want to store this image, I have to use 2 raised to 8, and it was 256, I have to use it. Okay, so that in this case it's become 256 is the highest one, or sorry, 255 is the highest one, and 0 is the lowest one. In such case, this way the threshold link function will convert the image either in 255 or either in 0, that means completely black or completely white. Okay, so this is the thresholding value or thresholding function which will convert the image into the black and white form. Okay, so when you select the effect of black and white, kabhi dekhna Word, PowerPoint, not only this bit from which you are very much familiar, but nowadays in your smartphone there are some camera tools are available, effects are available. You just click on that, and once you capture the image, your captured image is in the form of black and white completely, because the formula is going on behind this particular tool. So it's a very simple formula, it's a very conditional formula of thresholding function which will convert your image into form of RGB. So first of all, when you convert your when you capture the image by your camera, it will in RGB form, then it's converted into gray, and then it will convert into black and white. So this is the pathway of this particular task. Not only that, individually you can also convert this particular RGB component in the form of black and white with the use of this particular function. Now second transformation functions we are going to discuss, which is it's a list actually. Identity function, first there is some mathematical stuff I'm just taking it. Identity function, that means the input and output are same. Number one. Negative matlab completely opposite of this particular input. How it will be converted in negative, we will see. Then this is ant power, ant root functions, logarithmic transformation, inverse logarithmic transformation. So different kind of transformation, any different kind of effects you are going to give to particular object or particular image of the particular object through which you can get the transformation. One by one we will see some real time example also, and one by one we will see what is the role of this particular function to enhance the image in which kind of situation. Okay, first of all we are talking about image negative transformation. So image negative, that means intensity is converted into the maximum. Suppose 0 to 255 is intensity value. If intensity value of a pixel is 5, and if you want to find a negative of it, so you just subtract it from 255 or subtract it from 255, it will get, you know, 250 minus 5. So it is a completely opposite of this given particular input value. So S is equal to L minus 1 in minus R. L minus 1 minus R. If we take an example, there is a small example of negative image. Here is the matrix I have taken. So how much bit, so how many bits are required? Maximum is 63, such that 6 bit is enough to store this image. So I am taking the 6 bit. So L is equal to 2 raised to 6 is equal to 64. So L value is 64, and L minus 1 is become 63. So your image become either whatever image you have, intensity value of this matrix have, it will convert into form of negative. Like if R is equal to 0, then S become, but it transform to 0 to directly 63, because 63 minus R. If the pixel value is 10, it will convert to 53. Similarly, if it is a 63, then it will convert to 0, where 0 is completely bad. And if you increase the value of intensity value of this particular pixel, it becomes lighter. So here the example, this matrix is given. I have just converted into this particular negative form. These are the values, and if you see the output of this particular image, you will get exactly opposite of this. So if it is more black, more white, more white and more black. Okay, so this is image negative, and if you draw the graph of this particular object, you will get the negative slope of this particular object. Okay, so this is the negative. So what is the role of this negative image? Sometimes the visual quality is not visible. Okay, something like that. Here the original image, the digital mammogram of a breast, where suppose there is a breast cancer over there, and the spot of the cancer spot is not as much visible in this particular mammogram, because the spots are white here in this way, and remaining portion are black. But suppose the background is white and the foreground, that means the spots are white, black, then it's clearly visible for the observation. So you would just give the negative transformation and you will definitely get a better result. Now the visual quality, remaining backgrounds are white and the spots are always in a form of black color. So it is clearly visible how much it is spreaded out in the particular mammogram. So this is the role of image negative, where some object, for it is a transform, it is a changing between foreground and background. So if foreground is important, yeah, definitely no need to transform. If background is important, definitely you have to take the negative image and you will get a better background and better visualization of the background. So this is the role of image negativity. Most and very important, and I prefer this in many situations, and I have used this particular transformation in many situations. Simple function is S is equal to C into log of 1 plus R. That means a log transformation. C is a constant and R is greater or equal to 0. So C is a controlling parameter which will control how much it can be transformed from one to another form. Okay. So if you see the graph here, input level, and here you can say that output layer. So here input and output S, input R, output S. If you closely observe here, the intensity, the value of particular input value from 0 to L by 4, that means if your image quality is dark, which means that the intensity value is varying from 0 to L by 4. L is the maximum, so 1/4 part. Okay, so what it will do, the less frequency log will convert in a high frequency. That means more dark value is become more lighter. Why? The high intensity is converted into the moderate, high frequency. So advantage of this particular log transformation is that when you capture, if you see the example, better I will show you. Yeah, see the example here, more dark image converted more white. Okay, so very dark image is converted into more white image. Where C, constant C is nothing but 45.986. This is the formula is used, where C is equal to 255 is the highest intensity value. Log of 1 plus 255 is the highest maximum intensity value of this particular image. And if you set 45, it will give you a better result. Otherwise, you can take any constant value. So if you observe this image, it's a grayscale image, it's very dark. The pattern, the circular pattern, which is not clearly visible in this particular object. But if you use a log transformation that C is equal to 1, I have taken over here, then it is clearly visible over here. So what is the advantage of it? So many times what happened, suppose you have a function at your auditorium, you have a function at your home, and suppose in auditorium especially, you know that there is a performance on the stage, or there is only light on stage, maybe possible some spotlights are there only, remaining portions are so dark and audience side is totally black. And suppose there is a task of photography is assigned to you and you have captured a photo. So you have to capture, you have two different views. One is the view of stage where the performer is performing its art, his or her art. And second viewer is of your audience. So yes, definitely you have to capture both. So what happened? On the stage, there is only spotlights. The lights are very much lower, and when you capture image, it is always dark. And if you move towards the audience are totally dark. Some of the light, some of the reflection of the lights are there, and some of the only very lighter face are there is visible in the audience. You definitely in this live phenomena you have captured the image. You cannot on the light of you cannot switch on the light of the particular auditorium you have captured. Right. After the completion of function, suppose you want to upload your photographs or you on the website of your website or on a brochure you have to print out it, you have to take print out of it. What happened? The image is there. What you will do? Once the image is captured, then it is not many. So out of so many pictures, you scrutinize it, you will select only those pictures which has a better quality. Though, one picture you have captured which has a very good, angle, very good expression of the audience, very good pose by the performer. But what happened? The image is dark. While the other images are lighter, but it is not that much meaningful for you. So what happened? Unfortunately, you have to upload that particular lighter image on website, rather you want to upload your image on this particular image of the particular post. So at that time, what we can do after particular capturing of the image, you can use log transformation, you can enhance the image with the clear visualization. Okay, not only that, night photography is very much important aspect, and many functions we are celebrating on night, in which we are capturing our event with the use of mobile phone, and mobile phone has not that much capacity of flashing the light, so that definitely you have a dark image. So you can enhance this image, you can visualize the feature of this particular object with the use of log transformation. So this is, I think it is very important to enhance our image using log transformation. You can use it. Okay, now gamma correction, image processing. Gamma correction is most important because it enhances the contrast level of the image, because it has a capacity, it has a both capacity. If your image is too much dark, you can make it lighter, then you can make it lighter. If the image is too much lighter, you can make it sufficiently dark. So gamma function, this gamma correction method has an advantage of transformation of both the way, dark to light, light to dark. This is why these gamma functions are very much useful as a pre-processing of image before processing the image. Okay, so normal, in the normalization stage, most of the persons are using gamma correction method. Very simple formula. There is no that much mathematical stuff over here. S is equal to C is any constant, we know that. I any input value, and gamma is any constant value, gamma. Then the improvised gamma correction method is S into C, S is equal to C into R plus epsilon raised to gamma. Why it is epsilon? Epsilon, mathematics mein aap log padhte honge ki epsilon is a smallest positive integer. Yes, definitely it is not zero, but it is little bit more than zero. Why it is added over here? Because sometime, suppose your R value, yani input value is completely black or zero, then there is something over that which will convert into the S, such that if R is sometime where R is zero, epsilon will help to make this gamma correction possible. Otherwise, if it is zero, zero resource, anything, answer is zero. Nothing will be done over there. Such that we are using here epsilon. So this is an improvised formula with the use of gamma correction. Okay. So if you see the graph, if gamma value is one, so whatever original image and what is whatever original image after gamma correction method, it remains as it is, right? But if you can see over here, if you increase the gamma value, the graph says that it becomes more darker. And if you decrease the value of gamma from 1, you have a very lighter value. So this control is in your hand, how much image you want to make dark, how much image you want to make lighter, with the simple formula of gamma correction. Let me take an example. This is a well standard example. Yeah, the this is an MRI fracture in human spline with C is equal to 1. Here the spline, the original image is very much dark and it is not clearly visible. The observer want to make it more, you know, lighter way, a lighter form, such that the fracture can be visible, more visible. So yes, the gamma correction, you can say that 0.6, 0.4 and 0.3. As usual, I have already explained it. If you reduce the gamma, it becomes lighter. So here the images become lighter. How much lighter you want the image, it's depend upon you, how much gamma you will consider. Okay. Now, this is from dark to light. Dark in the sense, you know, dark to wash out, actually, not light. Wash out is a better word. Wash out image. Okay. And sometime you have a washout image. So definitely all of you are photographer and very expert photographer you are, because nowadays you, all of you have a camera in your hand. So you know many, many things, how to capture camera, which angle should be there, what, how much light should be on object, in front of light or on the back of light you have to capture, you have to take your camera, you know everything. So sometimes what happened, there is an event is going on, there is a birthday party you are celebrating, and there is a candle over there. Your friend or your relative is blowing the candle, and there is a light of candle, and you are capturing the object in front of light. What happened? You have a washout image. You have a washout image. Not only that, in a room, suppose, you know, first concept, first light, I have explained that key. Light is coming from the illumination source, and it should be thrown on the object. वो ऑब्जेक्ट के ऊपर गिरनी चाहिए, नहीं कि कैमरा के ऊपर. सो मोर लाइट इज थ्रोइंग ऑन द ऑब्जेक्ट, द ऑब्जेक्ट्स बिकम मोर विजिबल. बट व्हाट हैपेंड, सपोज योर कैमरा इज इन फ्रंट ऑफ लाइट एंड योर ऑब्जेक्ट इज बिटवीन द लाइट एंड योर कैमरा, व्हाट हैपेंड, यू विल डेफिनेटली गेट वॉश आउट इमेज. और कई बार हम लोग खींच भी लेते हैं वॉश आउट इमेज, बिकॉज देर इज नो एनी स्पेस वेयर यू हैव अ एंगल और स्पेस थ्रू विच यू कैन कैप्चर द इमेज विच इज behind this particular light. Okay, so once you have captured the event is completed and the photography has been done. But what happened? The event cannot be repeated again and again. But the image, what about the image? What you will do with the image? So here is the example: a satellite image or aerial image. Satellite, not, it's an aerial image by drone or any instrument. Okay, so daylight image. There is a sunlight, lot of sunlight over there, and the image is washed out. There are some objects on the earth which is not clearly visible. So Definitely, I have to use gamma correction method. I am just increasing my gamma such that this becomes more darker. When it is sufficiently dark in which I can observe all the object on the earth, I will stop. Okay, so it's depend upon observer ki how much he or she want a darker image. So here the two role of gamma correction. One is dark to washout image you can convert, and washout image to dark image. So gamma correction is most important when the image processing is concerned, and the pre-image processing, this is widely used. Now the contrast stretching function. Yeah, the contrast stretching functions. There are two points you are selecting on the graph, and you are moving this object between this particular interval. Say the R1 S1 and R2 S2 are the two points, and you are stretching the particular object between this frequency value, and you will get the answer. Let me take an example. This is the image, and this is the original graph, original visualization of the image through the software, and some of the value you have chosen. The intensity, two points we have chosen, 20, 30, and 40, 50. Once you have plotted on this graph and you have chosen two points, and now you are stretching this particular image. They have three section, alpha, beta, and gamma. Hello, any question? Yeah, it's okay. So there is a three section, and with the use of three section and the formula, the condition you can change accordingly, and you will get this enhancement of the image. Now this is the example. If you see the image enhancement through the example, real time example, you will definitely get a better idea. Okay, so it is a pollen magnifying 700 times and a microscopic image of 8-bit image. So if you see this image captured by this particular microscope, it is very washout kind of thing. There is no any contrast level. Contrast level is nothing but contrast is always the difference between foreground and background. So when object should be visualized in a better way, definitely background is dark and foreground must be lighter. Okay, so focus and defocus, you can also say that, which is another concept, but in this context you can use it. So here the contrast level, that means the object are clearly differ from each other. It is a nothing but a contrast. So here the whole image having same intensity, almost similar intensity value, and it is not clearly visible. So contrast is increasing by this particular way. So R1 S1, where R minimum input value and 0, R2 S2 is nothing but maximum L minus 1. This is the output. And now suppose you use, this is the contrast stretching function we have used. And now suppose again on this contrast stretching function, suppose you will use a thresholding value, it will be very much visible. And every spot of this, every spot on this particular pollen is visible, visualized clearly. So these are the methods. Here is a combination of two different enhancement method, mathematical method. One is a thresholding. One is first they have used contrast stretching function, and second one they have used a thresholding function. Through it, the contrast level is become more visible. In your television, you know that once you have a television channels are there, every channel has their own visual quality, and suppose some channel have this kind of visualization, definitely you have to take the remote and you have to enhance the contrast level of this particular channel. Okay, so if you have a facility of this particular, every television has a facility, but what happened, it is not it is not applicable to particular channel to channel. So ultimately the visualization of this particular channel is not by the channel is broadcast by the broadcaster, but it is a visual quality for television. So actually you are changing the visual quality of the television through this particular remote. So once you apply it on one channel, it will be applicable for all channels. Yeah, there is some technology maybe over there, one by one. Yeah, the broadcaster can change over there sometime, that they are changing this particular setting directly. Okay, but this is the thing which can be implement to enhance the contrast level of this particular image. Okay, now intensity level slicing method. So yeah, this is slicing method is say that you decide one interval. I have decided 20 to 40, and I have to change this interval. Means I in this particular frequency, I want to use my intensity level slicing method. That means in this interval, whatever intensity value of this particular pixel, it becomes to very lighter, and remaining, which is not beyond this, which is not belong to the particular interval or beyond this particular interval, it will be becomes zero. So you are clearly focusing on a particular object which should be the highlighted, and remaining must be becomes the background. So the slicing method is applicable on the focusing the particular object. Okay. Again, this is the function where again I'm checking 20 and 40 is the interval in which the pixel value is increased by and remainings are remains as it is. I'm not interfering on this particular intensity value. I'm just considering only intensity value between 20 to 40 and which are to be enhanced with the use of this particular intensity level slicing function. Yeah, this is the example of particular image. So it is a aortic angiogram near the kidney area. The first image, which is not clearly visible. Now the second, what it intensity is intensity selected upper and left grayscale. So here it is an enhancement over there. And now again I am using this particular stretching function. On the basis of that, some vessels are clearly visible over here. So medical side, this is the application of medical. So the mathematics is in background, digital image is there, and application of digital image in medical form. So definitely, when if you go for the MRI, or if you go for the CT scan, or if you go for the X-ray in any hospital or any laboratory, if you go over there, you can see that the visual quality. I have seen that the particular person who is capturing the image, after capturing the image, there is some software over there before printing on this particular particular transparency or whatever material they are using, they adjust the particular intensity value or particular image quality using different transformation functions. Though they are not working on background, they have just a GUI, graphical user interface. They have just GUI interface where they just drag the button. Okay, they are just drag the button, just like we drag the volume button and the volume is increased. So it's a GUI application. They just drag the button, which means that they are dragging. That means they are setting the intensity value or the interval in which they want to visualize the object clearly. If I want to enhance this area surrounding the kidney, so I will select that particular region and I will just increase the slicing method and intensity value of this particular object in this particular region only with the use of this function. Okay, so background is in background, there is a mathematical form over there, but you know that we are very much familiar with the software, especially GUI version. Sometimes it's very much dangerous if you are a researcher and if you are doing a research work on using image, whatever applications you have. But suppose you are using image processing, and suppose some ready-made commercial or open source software are there, and suppose you use ready-made function which is already available in a software, then you can do it. But suppose which is not actually in your control, whatever facility provided by software, you have to follow that facility. Whatever property of the software, you have to follow that property. But suppose you want to do your own way, because this is the research work, when and where it will be modified, you never know. Okay, I will discuss later one issue, but this is the basic concept. When you do your research work, the whole control of the system should be in your hand. Only then you can perform according you want. Okay, so this is the actually phenomena. Okay, so most and very important, bit place slicing. So nowadays we know that compression. Can anybody tell me what is the latest compression method is applicable? Some of you have this compression method in your camera also. Anybody tell me about what is the latest compression method which compressed the image in a bigger way, in the highest compression with low, the less reduction of the quality? Can anybody know the highest? Actually, you are using, some of you maybe know about it, and some of you are using actually it is. Do you know the latest compression method? Have you heard the word MPEG? MPEG? Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir, you are audible, sir.
Have you known the MPEG version, MPEG file format, MPEG dot MP4 to pata hi hoga sir ko, MP4?
Yes, yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So MPEG 1, MPEG 2, MPEG 4, then I have H.AVC, then H.264. H.264, and nowadays in your camera, if you can see that HEVC, this is called H.265, the latest compression technique, which if you select that particular setting, if you go to your camera setting and if you select an HEVC, likha hoga HEVC, high efficiency video coding system, okay, video coding, then if you select, if you on this HEVC technology, whatever video you are capturing, this is compressed by the HEVC encoder. And yeah, if you want to see that video, you have to use that those instrument which support HEVC. But you know, nowadays your mobile is supporting, but maybe your laptop is not supporting HEVC. Once you capture your video or image, especially video with HEVC, then you can see the video in your mobile, because your mobile has facility to run this particular video. Video is a sequence of image actually, but your laptop might not have that much capacity to run HEVC. So what is the role of HEVC and what is the role of compression? Nowadays you know that you are very much engaged in the capturing of TikTok, though India has banned this TikTok, but there are some applications over there. So TikTok is a favorite video capturing, video shooting are there. Once you capture a video, and suppose you want to upload on this particular social media platform, you know that how much data is required, because your internet, yes, thanks to Jio and other internet provider, ki nowadays we are having that much, you know, but still we are having HD and ultra HD and super HD video we are capturing away in a mobile, and suppose want to upload, definitely it will take a lot of data, it will consume a lot of data, and sometimes your internet speed is not that much high such that the video cannot be uploaded, okay? So this is quite difficult. So in that case, what we have to do, we have to compress the video. But what happened, if we compress the video, we are reducing the quality of video, is it so? No, we have to compress a video which reduce the size of a video, but which should not be reduce the quality of the video, such that this kind of compressions are applicable, HEVC and H.264. If you see the WhatsApp, once you have captured a video or image, and if you share this video or image on WhatsApp, WhatsApp having their own compression method which automatically reduce the size of this particular image or video on other hand, and the image will be definitely reduced. So so this is the thing. One more thing. Nowadays when I started, I have a 1 GB, 2 GB, 3 GB, 5 GB, 16 GB, 18 GB, something type of hard disk, or 34 GB hard disk, or 50 GB hard disk. But nowadays we are talking about TB, because we have a HD and high HD videos to be stored. But suppose we have a limited storage capacity, and suppose we want to store high resolution video or image, what we have to do, we have to capture a video, we have to compress a video. Compress doesn't mean ki only zip compression, that means we will discuss a huge field of compression, video compression, but it will reduce the size of this video, so that we can store more. And not only storage, but transmission over a network, it is very much helpful for us. So this is one of the compression method in which this this kind of stuff is used. But this is another concept. Bitrate slicing is very interesting and very wonderful. If you, I will explain with the example. Okay, so as we know that bit, aapko pata hai, bit plane, there are 8-bit image. This is an example. Suppose I have taken ek example of 4-bit, sirf main 4-bit le raha hu. This is a matrix, or this is an image having pixel value something like this, and the maximum value of this particular image is 15. So I am taking only 4-bit plane, I am taking only 4-bit. You can see that 1010, every pixel value having binary conversion of only 4-bit. I can take only, agar maine 255 le liya, then I can always have 8-bit, 8-bit, 1100110, total 8-bit should be there. But here for example, I am taking only 4-bit, okay, for example. Then after we move towards the 8-bit. So 4-bit planes are there. If I separate the 4 bits, yani first bit I will separate first columns of each, then second, any 2:0, 2:1, 2:2, 2:3, something like that. So it is called a bit plane 1, bit plane 2, bit plane 3, bit plane 4. So I have separated 4-bit plane. Okay, similarly, this is the original image I have performed in a software. This is a dollar image. This is the 8-bit gray image, matter the value of this particular image is varying from 0 to 255. If I separate all bit planes, so you can see that 8 number bit plane, yani 2 raised to power 7, 2 raised to power 7, and first bit plane, that means 2 raised to power 0. So the contribution of making the image, the dollar image, there are 8 planes are contributing with each other to make this successful dollar image. When the highest contribution of 8 plane, then 7 plane, 6 plane, 5th plane, then 4 plane, 4th number plane is little bit, then 3rd plane, 2nd plane and one for the first plane, they will have a little contribution in the construction of the dollar image. Okay, now we will see the reverse process. Okay, suppose okay, the reverse process says that how bit plane is multiplied with first bit plane is multiplied with 2 raised to 0, 2 raised to 1, 2 raised to 2 and 2 raised to 3, you will get this particular matrix again, and if you sum up this all matrix, you will get the original matrix. You can see, you can take one example, the right corner, right top corner, 8 plus 4 plus 1, 8 4 12 0 1, and 13, so it's become 13. So this is the reverse process. So why should we use this reverse process concept? Okay, so dollar image, if we combine only 8 in 8 bit plane image, 8, yeah, I have to go forward and backward. If this is the original image consisting 8 bit planes, total 8 bit planes, so it consumes more memory. While this is the combination of 8 number and 7 number, that means 8 plus 7, and if you see that the visual quality of this. Now if I add 8 plus 7 plus 6, this is again, and if I add 8 plus 7 plus 6 plus 5, this is almost nearer to the particular original image, which means that I am not interested to store all 8 bits which consume more memory. That means 4 bit 3 bit 2 bit and 1 bit, I am not going to take it. I am just taking, out of 8 bit I am taking only 4 bit planes, and I just store this image in only this combination of 8 7 6 and 4. A bit. So what happened? Half of the memory is saved by this technique. So if you have captured your image, you know that your image 18 megapixel, 20 megapixel. Nowadays you have a high megapixel camera. Now, one camera come for gaya, then just Samsung and Oppo and all these have used 2 camera, 3 camera, 4 camera. That means number of more pixels to be captured. Or this is how say, you know, your memory is increased, 32 bits, 64 bit, 128 bits, okay, sorry, GB, GB are using. But what, once you capture your image in a high resolution, one image having resolution, you know, 18 megapixels, 14 megapixels, 20 megapixels, a high resolution image, it's taking 10 MB, 15 MB, 20 MB, 25 MB, the It consumes the memory. So you know, 124 MB is nothing but 1 GB almost. So if you consume 5 MB, 7 MB, 10 MB, 25 MB, that means after one session of half an hour, you will have a lot of memory consumption. So, and we will store that image in our camera or memory as it is. Not only that, if you want to upload on social media, definitely we just go to Facebook and upload that image. Not only one image. More than one image, and nowadays story making are there. You are not uploading only one image; you are uploading the sequence of image. So you know it consumes. When you upload your data on Facebook or whatever social media you are using, it takes a lot of consumption of your internet data. But suppose your aim is to show the actual image, whether it is an 8-bit or 4-bit. If the half of the image, but of the four combination of 8 7 6 5 is sufficient to visualize your object, then it's, you have no need to use other 4 bit plane. So half of the memory can be saved using this particular technology. So this is the bit plane slicing method. It's very much useful. You can make it your own way also. Yeah, for me it is not facilitated over there, but suppose you are using any software, you can make your own code also. We are performing this all thing in our students are performing this in this particular laboratory, where they are making all the functions by their own way. They are not using ready-made function. But suppose you are not familiar with the coding or with MATLAB or Octave or any image processing software, you just use GUI tool where this particular function is available, through which you can separate it and you can combine again it using use the with the use of this particular bit plane, and this is how you can save the memory. Now third and next most and very important is histogram equalization. So histogram equalization, what is the role of histogram equalization? What is histogram? Histogram shows the frequency of intensity value of the particular pixel. So if you see this image, first image, it is a dark image. So here the, if you draw the histogram, the graph is varying from almost 0 to less than 100. All the value of pixel is between 0 to 100. You can see that, such that this image is dark. If we see this image, the intensity value is varying from 140 to around 255. So it is a higher value of the intensity value, such that it is a white, yani a washout image. And all the values between, you know, between 90 to almost 140, then the all pixel values are similar, sorry, all pixel values having similar intensity value, which shows that we have already discussed the contrast level. If pixel values are similar, then all the objects are, all the pixels value are, you know, same intensity value, having same brightness, such that it is low contrast image. Okay, while the intensity value is varying from 0 to 255 uniformly, then you have a high contrast image, the clear vision. So what can we do? Once we have captured the image having this kind of phenomena or this kind of situation, how we can set this particular image by enhancing the contrast level? I'm not going inside the mathematical stuff, okay, because we are actually we are very much close to the ending of the session. So I'm just using, okay, low contrast, high contrast. Yeah, this is the monotonic increasing functions, strictly monotonic increasing functions, probability functions are there, derivative concepts. I'm not going inside. Yeah, if you see the image, after implementing the histogram function, all the image, whether it is a dark, whether it's a light, whether it's a low contrast image, it is converted into sufficiently contrast image. And if you see the histogram of each and every image, after the histogram, after the implementation of histogram, you can see that it is uniformly almost distributed, such that it is a high contrast image. So this is the role of contrast image. Okay, now smoothing and sharpening. Smoothing, that means blur. When you know, now the camera having facility to blur your image, focus and defocus object, aapka background agar blur karna hai, then you can use this smoothing function. Some of the functions are very much useful. Simple functions, mathematical formula, you know that averaging the filter, which is known as a low pass filter, average matlab sum of all this particular value divided by jitni value hai, yani 9, sum of all this value and divide by 16. So this is the known as average function, which is known as low pass filter. If you use 1 1 1 1 1 all the value, which is not, which is called as a box filter, and suppose you are using this different value, which is called a weighted average function. So g f of x y is the input value and w is a mask or filter, you can say that. You just put that filter on the particular image and just move from pixel to pixel, one by one, pixel to pixel, you just move it. The center value is replaced by the averaging, center value is replaced by the weighted averaging, and it becomes a blur. So this is the function where the sum of sum is multiplication of this, okay, and averaging. So I'm just taking an example, original image, I have taken the mass of 3 by 3, because if I take 3 by 3, then 9 pixel over there and center, you are getting this value. You can see on left hand side also. Okay, either you can take 3 by 3, 5 by 5, 7 by 7, such that you will have a center value. Okay, now this is the original image. Slowly and gradually, I am using the mask M, 3 by 3 pixel, and just moving from pixel to pixels, and I am getting the blur image of this particular image. Then I am using, I am increasing my size of this particular pixel or mask. So it is a 5 by 5 matrix, it's become more blur, 9 by 9, 15 by 15, 35 by 35. So the more, thus increasing of the size of a mask, increasing the blurness in the particular image, and focus and defocus. Okay, so here the Hubble space of telescopic image, where the mask of 15 by 15 is used, and then the threshold is used. Clearly, the satellite image is very much used, visible, and the galaxies, different galaxies are clearly visible over here, and it can be spotted on a particular image. Another function is median filter. Median filter is nothing but most and very important. It reduces the salt and pepper. Salt yani namak, white, pepper yani black spot. So you might have experienced that. Suppose there is an evening session, late evening, there is a sunset over there. Sun has already sun is already set over there, and there is a little bit light in your in the environment or atmosphere. And now you have captured one image. You can see that there is some black and white dots over there. Okay, so this is a low light photography, always having salt and pepper kind of noise. So how you can remove that particular noise of this particular image with the use of median filter. So median formula, you know that median formula is nothing but if you have a pixel value of 3 by 3, you just set in the increasing way, whatever middle value is there, you just replace that pixel value with the middle value, and such that you will get a better quality of that image. This is the example. This is an image of a circuit where it is so many black salt and pepper, yani black and white type of spots over there. Now I have used 3 by 3 over there with the use of average function, yani mass average mass function is used over here, any box filter or weighted average filter. But suppose I use median filter, see the quality difference between them, how many spotted over there and the quality enhancement over there. So almost all the salt and pepper noises are reduced by this particular median filter. Okay, can start. You have a camera now. Most of the camera having the facility. Once you want to capture an object, you just focus on it. Your triple or four camera will capture the background. One camera will capture the foreground, and the foreground is separated. But the foreground is highlighted, and background is. But the foreground is becomes sharp. Is sharpening process is used on foreground, and smoothing process is used on background. And on the run time, you will capture a very defocused image. You know, pre-wedding shooting over there. So you know there are two concepts. During any runtime you can capture, or with the use of Photoshop or any other software, you just select foreground and separate them in a two layer, one layer and foreground and background layer. You are applying smoothing method, and through which you can just separate this foreground and background, and you can have a very smooth and sharp foreground and background defocused image, which you will laminate on the day of marriage, okay, not and also on in your album. Okay, Laplacian filter, I'm not taking much time. Okay, so this is the Laplacian function. I can discuss it, the Laplacian function. Mansi madam, exactly 4 o'clock.
Yes sir. Hello.
Okay, so we have still 7 minutes, so I'm just concluding. Yes, I have just 7 minutes. I'm just concluding it. So using this particular Laplacian filter, you can see that these are different filter which can be used during Laplacian filter. This is the image of moon, where this is very, you know, blur kind of image, and here the last image, you can see that is a very sharp image. The spot of the image or this particular is implemented. Now this is very much useful. Some of the students, master students, they are applying for ISRO. Where Ahmedabad, especially, they are using for image processing. Even in Dehradun, they are using a remote sensing over there, and in Chennai, and they are using Bangalore, actually not Chennai. They are using the satellite image. So when you go over there, definitely the images are captured. Satellite images are captured over there, and students are given a project to clear that particular image and separate the features of the object coming from this particular image. Then you have to separate it using this particular. methods. So here, these methods are very much useful for the enhancing the image. Scaling Laplacian, which will, yeah, the age detection. This is one of the concept we will discuss later on if it is time permit. Unsharp marking and hybrid filtering. You know that this is an example. I'm just come to over there. This is an image text. You know, when you scan a document or when you capture a photo, you know there is a CAM scanner or Adobe scan over there. There is, once you capture an image, you have to steady your camera. Otherwise, it becomes a blur. Your text becomes blur. But suppose you are very in hurry and you have just taken, you know, you have very less, you know, in a fraction of time you have just captured an image with the use of CAM scanner or Adobe scan or any other scanner. And suppose it is, you know, the camera was not that much steady in that time. So whatever text document you have captured, the documents are the whole documents become blurred, and all the characters on this particular documents become blurred. So how you can clear this blurness, and how you can make the text is more visible and more sharp, which is, you know, this is the tool of sharpening method. Unsub masking and high boost filtering, through which you can clear, this is the input value and this is the final output value through which you can use it, you can clear this particular image or text and become more sharper. So this is the mathematical formulation. It's very easy. Gaussian filter, an average mass filter, and you just take the difference and create a mass. With the mass, you will use this k value. It's nothing but a coefficient which will control how much you want to make it more sharper. So if k is increasing, you will definitely get a high boost filtering, and you will get a more accurate result. Okay. So this is a gradient. This is the functions. Robert Cross gradient operator and Sobel operator. So age detection, many of you, suppose you are doing a research work and suppose you want to use an age detection. So age detection, one of my students has used a lifeline classification with the use of image processing neural network classifier. He has used, in which the Kahneman as a feature, we have taken lines of this particular age of the particular fingerprint or a palm print, in which the Sobel, in which the Kahne is the most an important method which will detect ages only of this particular object, and in which if you explore the Kahne method, in which the Sobel operator is used, which will separate the ages from the object. So this is the Sobel operator is very much useful. And if you see this example, here is the lens, there is a damage over here, but it is not clearly visible. So what we will do, we will just detect the age of this particular lens only, and here you can see that clearly damaged line of this particular lens, corner of this particular lens. So this is how different formula has a different purpose, and for a different purpose you can use the different mathematical functions that can be useful for image enhancement. Okay, thank you very much for
giving
the time. Any question, query?
If anything important, yes. Left, sir, then you can take more than 5-10 minutes, sir.
No, it's okay. My advice for you is, before I conclude it, let me give an example of a research person. A person is in our university, one person is doing a PhD from, she is very, you know, experienced teacher, professor, and she is doing PhD in the field of image processing. And what happened actually, she is using a,
hello,
actually a neural network, but she was using MATLAB software in which ready-made functions are there for CNN, convolutional neural network. So what happened, the parameter and the functions are already set in a particular function only. So actually she has modified its PhD modeling, mathematical modeling she has modified, but software is not accepting it. So she came to me and asked for this particular, prepare your own code, any customized neural network, or you are using ready-made functions. She said, I am using ready-made functions. So I told her, it is not possible for me to modify the code which is given by the software only. So what I suggest, when you go for image processing or MATLAB kind of stuff, in a morning session, one student asked one question. One person asked one question to Jayesh sir, okay, what is the, when the data is limited. So if you are dealing with the ready-made tool available in a software, it is very much difficult because they will not permit you to modify their own code. But suppose if you know the background of mathematics, what kind of process or what kind of mathematical formula is going on behind this particular tool, so that you can take the whole control in your hand, and you can modify this model as well, such that the customized model will help you to complete your research work as you want. Okay, so this is the actual thing. But nowadays we know that nobody is bothered about mathematical, you know, they don't like to make their own coding. They are not interested to, you know, go for mathematical formulation, and they just want to use the ready-made function. Yeah, it can be applicable, but if you want in your way, sometimes it has a limitation. That's all from my side. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, sir. Participants, now you can ask your question to Dr. Mukesh, sir. If there is any question related to this session, then you can ask.
If you are not asking questions, good afternoon, Mukesh. Either you understand everything, or you have.
There is.
Okay, good afternoon.
There is one question from my side, not related to the topics which have been covered, but generally in image processing, many times we go in the frequency domain to extract the information in better way. So generally we use the transformations like DFT, DCT, discrete sine transformations, wavelets, and others. Generally in all the compressions and all those modules, generally they go for cosine transforms because of the integers values that we are getting, which reduces the complexity. But can you just elaborate where we can use this discrete sine transformation? Is there any specific applications or something where we should not go for DCT and we should go for DHT? Mathematically, see, what gives the what is the better advantage of DHT over to DCT?
We cannot claim that DHT is better and DCT is better. It is basically depend upon the object of the image you are using as an input. Sometimes DHT is giving a better answer in case of DHT or DCT, and sometimes DCT is giving a better answer in case of DHT. But majorly nowadays researchers are using DCT because it is observed that DCT is giving better answer in case of DHT. But one thing is over there. The fast Fourier transform FFT is more. It is also over there, but majority of the people are not using FFT because it's giving the complex value. And when you have a complex value, it is very much difficult to convert into binary form and further process. But one of my actually my wife is doing PhD in the field of security, in which we have used the FFT as a transform FFT fast Fourier transform as a transformation. And we have found that it gives a better answer because we have worked on a complex number also. But obviously, there is a complex number, that means a combination of real and imaginary number. It is very much difficult to deal with this particular number. So image compression is also over there. But cosine transformation is always applicable in a conversion in the frequency domain, where once you use the frequency domain, what I have observed that this smoothing and sharpening or whatever, they can be used in the frequency domain. DFT is giving a better rather than DCT.
Okay, sir.
Any other question?
Any question from the participants? Okay, thank you, sir, to share your deep knowledge of digital image processing with us. We able to know about how linear algebra, especially transformation, that is matrices, and also the interpolation, how it can be used to enhance the picture, and all other images can be modified and compressed. So thank you so much, sir. And we again meet tomorrow at the same time for your third session on modeling of partial differential equation.
I think it is at 2 o'clock.
It is at sir 2 or 2:30 p.m.
Okay.
Thank you all. We meet tomorrow at sharp 10 a.m. And do not forget to fill the attendance cum feedback form for all the sessions that is shared in Google Meet chatting. It is important for the certification. So thank you so much, all the participants. We meet tomorrow. Thank you all.
Thank you.